DHEA and Pregnenolone on TRT? Do you need to be on Pregnenolone and DHEA while being on TRT? Do men on TRT need Pregnenolone?
Well, I try to optimize all hormones in our practice. It's not just testosterone replacement in and of itself. I do use pregnenolone myself and for all my patients. It's well tolerated. The dosage that we use is 100 milligrams of a micronized sustained release capsule. We use it in the morning, take it morning or night. But we use it because pregnenolone is a memory enhancer. It improves cellular repair, particularly in the brain and the nerve tissue. It protects cerebral function. It's, you know, it can protect against neuronal injury. It's being studied for disorders like anxiety, depression, stress disorders, It's actually being studied for men that have had marijuana addiction. You know, they show that the pregnenolone levels diminish significantly on men that are exposed to THC. So it's good for some addictions. And so I find it to be a very, very good hormone. It's something that I do use. I don't measure levels of it because I found the levels to be inconsistent. But everyone tends to do well on the 100 milligrams. And it is the precursor. It's the mother hormone. It's the first hormone made from cholesterol. So I do try to supplement each of our patients with pregnenolone.
Okay. And it is supplemented with because FSH and LH are quite zero on TRT?
Right, that's correct. That's correct. Okay. They are. They go to zero.
Yeah. Okay. And then second question, do men on TRT need DHEA?
Yep, yep. The hormones that I find that we should all optimize while on hormone replacement therapy, of course, is testosterone. There are times when we need to optimize thyroid. Women are real sensitive to thyroid and they need it, you know, a lot more than men from a clinical standpoint. We try to optimize DHEA. Pregnenolone, and I use melatonin at night. So those are all, and then vitamin D3, vitamin D3 is a hormone. So we try to optimize all of those, but DHEA works, you know, very synergistically with estrogen and testosterone and growth hormone. And, you know, anyone over age 40 should certainly consider supplementing with DHEA. It decreases your cardiovascular risk because it decreases your visceral body fat. I mean, you know, visceral body fat is the main killer. It's responsible for 12, 13 at least different cancers. And, you know, out of the hormones, there's five of them that'll decrease visceral body fat, and that's testosterone, thyroid, DHEA, estradiol, and growth hormones. So those are the ones that we focus on. It improves memory. It increases energy. It can be used as an antioxidant, antidepressant. You know, there's so many wonderful qualities of DHEA on its own.
And what's the dosing on the DHEA?
Well, for men less than 200 pounds, I'll typically start on a 50 milligram dose. If you're more than 200 pounds, 50 to 100 milligrams taken in the morning. Your hormones peak in the morning. We take our DHEA in the morning. I typically aim for a range in males of around 400 to 600. Okay. And typically they come in, if you come in deficient with testosterone and your others, you're going to be deficient in DHEA. And we do measure DHEA sulfate, the sulfonated version of DHEA. With women, now women can be very sensitive to it. They can have side effects, especially if they started on it when they're younger than 40. Specifically, they can get acne or hirsutism. So with women less than 50, we typically start with 10 to 15 milligrams in the morning. You really have to adjust that dose if they develop any side effects. If they're older than 50, 25 milligrams in the morning. And we typically aim for a range for women 2 to 250.
Mm-hmm. I read that Dr. John Chrysler said DHEA should be taken twice a day, the dinner dose, because it should help with growth hormone production as we sleep.
I've not seen any data to support that. Once again, I can't find any data to really support any specific time of day. But we do know that our hormones do spike in the morning and decrease as the day progresses, and that's where I want my melatonin to peak at night. So I tend to take it in the morning when all the hormones are at their peak.
Okay, just resemble the natural way.
The circadian rhythm, yep, natural circadian rhythm, that's right.